Hey, Rainbow here on a really windy day in South Florida. There's a big storm coming, but I'm going to try to get this in. I apologize for the noise. And let's take a look at what we're going to take out today. This is the 2024 Triumph Scrambler 1200X. Not the extended, right? That's the XE, and that one would be literally not even 2 inches longer than this one. That certainly has a higher seat, though. Anyway, Triumph 1200 Scrambler X. Let's take a look at it. All right, let's do this with the windy conditions here. A little break in the action. Let's do it. 2024 Triumph Scrambler 1200X can be yours in the United States for a starting price of $13,595. This is the X, not the XE. The XE is just under 2 inches longer in wheelbase. That's about it. One of the things that this bike is known for is a lower seat height. We're gonna talk about that. Now, let's get in on the engine. Absolutely gorgeous. Okay, you are looking at a liquid cooled 8-valve parallel twin. That it is, of course, 1200 cc's. Now this monster will kick out about 66.2 kilowatts, let's call it 89 bhp, and that's at 7,000 rpm. What about torque, you say? Good question. All right, the torque on this rear wheel back here is 81.1 foot-pounds, about 110 newton meters, and that is at 4,250 rpm when this thing right here is cranking. As you can see, it's a pretty simple 2-into-2 exhaust. Now, this does have a wet multi-plate assist clutch and, of course, the gears. Let's talk about that. That is a 6-speed, 1 down, 5 up. This does not come with a quick shift. Now, somewhere in there, you can see that tubular steel frame right there, and the swing arm is a twin-sided aluminum, or those across the pond, aluminum. You have a big old 21 inch tire in the front, very typical for scramblers and bikes that are made for on and off-road use, and a somewhat normal sized rear tire that is 17 inches. So this front tire is a 90-90 21 inch, and the rear, of course, is a 150-70 R17, which is quite a typical size, easy to find. Now in the front, Marzocchi twins up here with no adjustment, but what they do have is 170 millimeters of travel, which is pretty good. Now coming back here, there's one on the other side that's kind of hidden by the exhaust, but right here we have another Marzocchi twin RSUs with piggyback reservoirs, as you can see right here. It does have a preload adjustment as expected, as they should. And surprisingly, this also has 170 millimeters of travel. Now, nothing fancy, but we do have twin 310 millimeter discs with 2-piston Nissans. And on the back, we have this monstrous looking Nissan back here, rear, and that has a 255 millimeter disc that uses it to stop. Really getting windy here, but we do have a multifunction TFT. This is a color screen for those that are curious. Now here's gonna make some people happy. This, for a Scrambler 1200, it is the X, has a 32 1/4 inch seat height. That's about 820 millimeters for the rest of the world. And this has a wheelbase of about 60 inches. You get almost 62 inches, about 61.8 if you went to the XE version, but I'm not positive on a seat height. If you guys are aware of the seat height on the XE, let me know. I think it's taller. Now this gorgeous gas tank will hold 3.96 US gallons or about 15 liters of fuel. If anyone wants to guess the wet weight of this puppy, let's see, 503 pounds, about 228 kilograms right there. And of course it has ABS traction control, and surprising to me, and I still don't understand why, why do we need 5 riding modes? Why do we need 3? Okay, I buy 3, right? But 5 riding modes? Come on, really? Tell me why. Explain me, what's your opinion on 5 riding modes? Bottom line, it has 5 riding modes. You know what? Let's take this thing for a spin.
Okay, folks, so I am praying that I have good audio. This is now, I am no longer using GoPro for these reviews. I now have the Insta360 Ace Pro. I do have to make an adjustment on the volume. We'll see, on the gain, I mean. Anyway, there it is, Triumph Scrambler 1200X 2024. Let's take it for a spin. All right. It is a Scrambler and it is a Triumph. So let's pull the clutch in, make sure the kickstand's up, and give it a start. Ooh, kind of sounds pretty good. Ooh, right out of the box, this sounds good. Oh shit, no shortage. Absolutely no shortage of torque. Feels really comfortable too. Like rather comfortable, I kind of like this. Let's see what we got going on here. Let's take it for a spin. Feels decently nimble. Kind of like the riding position here. Wow, torquey, power, love it. All right, so with the long seat, of course it's a scrambler, I can lean forward. I can go backwards if I have longer arms. I can find kind of a happy spot in the middle here. They are mid controls that feel pretty darn good here. Let's go one more time around the bend here. See how she feels. Love it. Now again, this does not have a quick shifter. It doesn't have to have a quick shifter. It's a motorcycle. They're always convenient. Good for when you're lazy, like me. But you know what? Feels really good. And as usual, it's a Triumph. It just feels very smooth. If someone ever said to me, describe Triumph motorcycles in one word, it would be smooth. That's the word you've heard come out of my mouth probably too many times. Probably way too many times. Beautiful. Manhole cover. All right, let's go the other direction. See how it feels. And then we'll take it on the road, take it on the highway, and see where we're at with this bike. Beautiful. Woo, lean into the turn. Feels good. Feels really good. So seating position feels good. The shifting, even though it's not a quick shift, it does feel very smooth, which goes right along with the engine. The torque on this low end here, not even hitting 4,000 RPM, is rather impressive. So this bike certainly has a decent amount of torque to it. When we get up to the stop sign here, I'll see what it feels like for sitting, for flat-footedness, and take it from there. Beautiful acceleration, nice. All right, I think I'm in neutral. Yes, I am. All right, I am 5'11". I have a 32-inch inseam, and I am easily flat-footing this bike. See that? Easily flat-footing this bike with my knees bent. So, very comfortable bike. And there is that new bike smell as the engine is heating up. All right, let's do this. Oh my goodness. Whoa, heads up. Okay, outstanding acceleration. I mean, really good acceleration. I am loving the acceleration on this bike. I really am. Truly am loving the acceleration. So the power delivery is definitely feels linear at these lower speeds like this. I mean, I'm doing 60. I think most people on most roads are going to probably be doing about 60 miles an hour, 65 miles an hour, maybe 70 on the highway. Bike feels really good. All right, let's talk about nimbleness. All right, well, you can definitely feel the gyroscopic effect on this bike for sure. 100% you can feel that gyroscopic effect. So I'm not going to say it's a very nimble bike. I also don't think it's expected to be a very nimble bike. All right, it is a scrambler. It does have a 21-inch wheel, so lower your expectations or buy a sport bike or a Ducati Multistrada Pike Speak or a regular, or a bike with a smaller front wheel. It does feel good, definitely feel that unsprung weight for sure, but yeah. For the size and weight and size of the tires, this bike feels very good. All right, let's try some braking here. Let's try to do some braking that's a little harder than normal. All right, see when the ABS kicks in. Yeah, well, the ABS definitely kicked in very early on this, so it seems like the ABS on this particular bike is a little on the aggressive side. Now, one of the things that I don't like about these particular scramblers is, I don't know if you could see it, when you come to a light and you want to put your right foot down, you're right up against the guard here, literally, right up against the guard with your leg where the pipes come, and it has a tendency to get a little bit too warm, if you ask me. Okay. They're turning red, I'm gonna turn green. There we go, and away we go. And I'll never make this light, we never do. The timing is just that, it's impossible. But what's amazing here, yeah, ABS is kicking in front and back, and the guy behind me I don't think was too happy about that. But I think he figured it out. Wow, acceleration. The bike just wants to pull away from you. The bike literally just wants to pull away from you. This is quite amazing. So this Scrambler 1200, and I rode some of the other Scramblers, but man, when you get to this 1200 level, you absolutely know that you are riding a 1200cc bike for sure. Definitely feels like it. I'll use the word, a very linear response is what it appears to be. It's comfortable at the stoplights. Like I said, you've got that heat when you put your right leg down. Your leg goes up and against the heat guard over the exhaust system. So that is going to be a problem. And also, hey, give me some comments on the audio. This is the first time I'm really playing with it, but this is with the new Insta360 Ace Pro. All right, people, let me go. Wow, it has power. Okay, 100 miles an hour coming up the ramp, and that's pretty good. Certainly no lack of power on this bike at all. Bit of a blind corner here. I want to make sure I can see what's in front of me, being on the outside lane. But yeah, now wind protection. Surprisingly, it doesn't feel that bad. I know it has no wind protection, but even in sixth gear at 82, 83 miles an hour, it actually feels pretty good. If you tuck in, you'll do a little bit better, but somehow, maybe it's the direction the wind's coming from, I don't know, but somehow it feels pretty comfortable. Let's do 100, 103, and very stable, very smooth, very stable bike at this speed. Of course, the idiot behind me in the Camaro was trying to pass me because I was moved over a little bit, which kind of pissed me off. Okay. It is very easy to find neutral on this bike. So one of the things that I did like about this is that this was very easy to find neutral. A lot of bikes, I find it difficult to find neutral. This bike was like, hey, I'm here. So this is surprising, especially for a new bike that's really not broken in yet. The fact that we're hitting neutral like so easily, I guess it says a lot about the way it's set up. So the only answer for the heat on your inside of your, kind of almost the back of your right thigh, right leg, upper right leg, is to put your left foot down, keep it in gear. That's kind of the best thing I can tell you. Don't put the right foot down when you come to an intersection, especially once a bike gets heated up, because you will absolutely feel it for sure. You will feel it 100%. Oh, and here comes the rain. That wasn't supposed to be here yet. Well, hey, I get to feel the bike in the rain, I guess. It's not the big band that's coming across, so this is just a little sporadic rain here. All right, let's take it over the railroad tracks, do the railroad tracks at about 50 miles an hour, see how she feels. Third gear, a little too far up. All right, I know it's coming from the west. I'm heading west, so I'm gonna probably get it. That little rain cloud right there is just gonna, all right, so let's keep this at about 50 miles an hour. And let's see, I'm expecting the railroad tracks to go over extremely well, because I have 170 millimeters of travel, front and rear, and of course, there it is, it was perfectly fine. Perfectly fine. All right, I don't want to get too wet today with this setup. So let's start heading back. And I think I'm pretty much wrapping this up here, because we got to feel just about everything about this on a quick little tour with this bike. Feels pretty darn good. And going back, we'll get to feel at a little bit of a lower speed the railroad tracks at 25 miles an hour. Yeah, if it's good at 55, it's gonna be good at 25. That's all I could say. Ooh, downshift, seemed to handle it well. Green light, let's take it, and let's run with it. Okay, who is this bike for? This bike is for someone who wants to update or upgrade an existing Scrambler user. This is more of a bike for a, let's say a more experienced rider. I would absolutely not recommend this bike for a new rider because of the amount of torque and power, and really both. You know, the torque as far as the acceleration and the horsepower, it's not that the horsepower is a big deal, but it's a heavier bike. Now, it is so smooth and it's so well engineered that can a new rider take this bike and run with it? Yeah, but probably someone who already has experience on motorcycles, you know, but maybe just got their license for the first time in years. Maybe somebody like that. But in many of your countries, I understand you can't ride this if you have a new, if you're a new rider anyway. You wouldn't be allowed to take a 1200 out. So the reality of it here is that this bike is not for the new rider because of the power. The fact that it has a lower seat and is a little more ergonomic, I think that might take away from my statement a little bit. So if you're on the fence and you're allowed to buy a 1200, I would do it, especially the price point that these Scramblers are coming in at, because I'm sure that you can take this on a decently long trip because it's so ergonomic and it has enough weight and enough power on the highway. Of course, you're gonna suffer with the wind over a long period of time, but that's something you get used to, and that's something you can learn to deal with. And that's about it as far as this bike for right now. Now, let's head back. Now, as always, I have to thank Two Wheels World in Pompano Beach, just north of Fort Lauderdale, and especially Ian, the salesman, and Omar, the owner, who allows me to take out these brand new bikes and test them out. So I could say that I'm extremely thankful that they allow me to do that. And it's because of that that I'm able to kind of get a hold of these and give everyone a bit of a preview on some of these newer bikes and some of the existing bikes that are maybe you just don't have an opportunity, or you live far away, or you have some questions on. I am a regular Joe, a regular guy, and the average rider. So do me a favor, please like, please subscribe. I'd appreciate it. That gives me some more clout to take some of these bikes out and give you my personal opinion on them. And that's about it. So that's important to me. If it's important to you, I'd appreciate it. I hope I can get in here without wrecking something, scratching something, especially with these new bikes and some used ones back here. But anyway, this is Rainbow. I was a little nervous doing this, right? Have yourself a great day. Bye-bye.